लाइफ इज फार इंटरनलाइजिंग द न्यूअर एंड ग्रेटर ट्रूथ्स. Krishna says, even if you are not able to internalize the great truths like soul is eternal, it is indestructible, and all these things, come on, even if you believe that birth and death are inevitable for this being, what you think as you, even then, you don't need to worry, because it is going to happen whether you worry it or not. You don't worry for day and night. You don't sit and cry, oh, now it is going to become night. What will I do? You don't sit and cry, oh, it is going to become daytime. What will I do? No. Once you know something is inevitable and moves like a cycle and eternal, you just learn to live with it. Learn to handle it. Same way, when you know life and death are inevitable, O Arjuna, foremost among men, is using the beautiful word for Arjuna, Mahabahu, the mighty armed one. It is not worthy of being mourned for this manner. You don't need to worry about it. He is using a very powerful name for Arjuna. Mighty armed one means, you see, the arms, the hands are directly related to giving. That is why when they describe Karna and Sri Ramachandra Prabhu, they describe their hands first. Even Sri Rama, supposed to be a great giver, Ramakrishna used to do. Whenever somebody comes to him and asks for sannyas, he will hold their hand and see. Hand is supposed to look big, very light. That is the scale. It should not look small and very heavy. He will say that only by holding the hand and weighing it, if it looks big and weighs light, then this guy will become sadhu. Means he has less engram and he has capacity to give away everything. Here, Krishna is describing Arjuna as Mahabahu. Means mighty arm. Surely Arjuna must have had the quality. Big hand, but light weight. Means the capacity to give everything. Capacity to give away. He's reminding Arjuna, hey, you are capable of giving away your body. Giving away everything. So don't worry. You are a great giver. I tell you, the joy of giving, the habit of giving, will bring its result in you when you leave the body. When you leave the body, person who is always giving, giving, who is habituated to depart from something which he feels as part of his life. If you are habituated for that, the leaving the body will be very easy. For example, you are having a house. For 10 years you lived in it, you felt it's almost your life. Suddenly one day morning you give it away. Now you are habituated to give away things which you feel as your life. Same way money. Sometimes you hold money as your life. Suddenly one day you give away. Same way. Sometimes you hold your comforts, luxury, pleasures as part of your life. Suddenly one day you give it away. Now you are habituated. You are trained for giving away what you feel as your life. So when you leave the body also, because of that habit, you will not have suffering. You are already habituated to give away. You can easily give away life also, body also. I tell you, the highest capacity you need to develop in the human life is capacity to give away. Capacity to go on giving. Giving your energy, giving your time, giving your love, giving your money, giving your, whatever you call it as yours, talent, capacity to give away. Atachainam nityajatam nityam vamanyase mrutam tatapitvam mahabaho. Every time when Krishna describes certain truths, he reminds Arjuna exactly that truth related name. He says, Mahabaho, mighty armed one who gave away everything, who is habitual giver. Nobody can give like Krishna. But he himself calls Arjuna as Mahabahu. Just to remind, Arjuna is a habitual giver. You are habituated for giving away. Don't worry. Don't be bothered. Be a giver. For a giver, life and death is not a big thing. He says, even if you believe that birth and death are inevitable for this being, even then it is not worthy of being known for in this manner. He says, even if you believe birth and death are inevitable, so why are you worried? It's a routine. Relax.